Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you factors affecting radar range. If you have seen my last two videos of radar engineering lecture series, in that I have explained equation of radar range. I have derived this equation of radar range. Rmax, that is radar range, that is equals to Pt G Ae into sigma divided by 4 pi square S mean and this raised to 1 by 4. Here Pt is transmitted power, G is gain of antenna, Ae is effective area of antenna, sigma is area of target and S mean, that is minimum detectable signal of radar. In this equation, we have G, that is gain of antenna. Usually with radar system, we use parabolic reflector antenna. For parabolic reflector antenna, gain is 4 pi Ae by lambda square. If you substitute G is equals to 4 pi Ae by lambda square, then further you can minimize this radar range equation. That will become Pt into Ae square into sigma divided by 4 pi lambda square into S min, this raised to 1 by 4. And based on this equation, you can easily understand different factors affecting radar range. See, radar range is Rmax, but obviously based on this equation, you can easily understand how many factors are there on which radar range depends. See, first is transmitting power on which radar range is directly proportional. Radar range that is directly proportional to Pt raised to 1 by 4, right? So here, as you increase transmitting power, you can increase range of radar. If you increase transmitting power by 16 times, you will be increasing range by double, right? And that you can understand based on this equation, Rmax, that is proportional to Pt raised to 1 by 4, right? So if you increase power by 16 times, you will be increasing range by double, right? Now, if you observe this equation carefully, second parameter is transmitting frequency. See, transmitting frequency f, that is c by lambda. Here c is velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8 in space. Usually radar is used for space, right? So here c will be 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So you can say frequency, that is directly proportional to 1 by lambda. If you observe this equation, so in that you see this Rmax, that is proportional to 1 by square root of lambda. So based on that, you can say this Rmax, that is proportional to square root of frequency, right? So as if you increase frequency, you will be increasing radar range. If you transmit frequency by 4 times, you will be having double of radar range, right? And as I have told you, see, Rmax is proportional to 1 by square root of lambda and frequency is proportional to 1 by lambda, means Rmax, that is proportional to frequency raised to half. So if frequency is getting 4 times, range is getting double over here, right? That is how frequency will modify radar range. Now third parameter, that is size of target area. This is very essential. See, size of target area, that matters a lot. And directly even in terms of layman's understanding, you should know. If size of target is smaller, then but obviously radar range will decrease over here. Larger the size of target, more the range of radar, that one can say, right? Nowadays you might be observing, like in India-Pakistan border, they used to communicate with the use of drones, and drones are not identified by the radar. Many of the students used to ask me like, sir, why drones are not getting identified by the radar? The reason is drone size is very less. And as size of drone is very less, range of radar, that is reducing over here, and that you can understand based on this equation even. You see, Rmax, that is proportional to sigma to the power 1 by 4. So if target area, that is decreasing, then radar range will also decreasing over here, right? So here, if target size is 16 times of the one target value, then radar range, that is also getting double over here, and that one can understand based on this relation. You can observe that in this equation even, right? Rmax is proportional to sigma to the power 1 by 4. And based on that, if sigma is getting 16 times, range is getting double over here. Right. Now, let us talk about another parameter, that is effective area of antenna, AE. See, effective area of antenna, that will be quite wider over here. The reason is, here we will be using parabolic dish antenna. Majority of radar that is using reflector dish antennas only. And with reflector dish antenna, size of effective area is wide, right? So here, if you have higher effective area, based on that, radar range will also increase. And for that, you need to see this equation. Here we have G in equation. So if you substitute G, then you will be having radar range in form of AE over here. So from this, you can say R max, that is proportional to AE to the power half, means R max is proportional to square root of AE, right? So if you increase effective area of antenna by 4 times, range is getting double over here. So in majority of applications, you will be observing, we are using large size antennas with radar, right? And on airports, even you will be observing radars are used, which is having larger size, right? The reason is, if you have larger size of effective area, in that case, range of radar, that is also increasing as per the proportion, which I have told you, where R max is proportional to square root of effective area. So if you increase effective area by 4 times, radar range, that is increased by twice, right? Now, last parameter, that is minimum detectable signal of receiver, that is S min. Here you can observe, we have radar range that is proportional to 1 by S min to the power 1 by 4. So here, if you have receiver which is detecting very weak signal, then your range of radar that is increasing, that one can say, right? So minimum detectable signal, that matters a lot. If you have higher sensitivity of receiver with radar system, then you can receive weak signal even. Usually, when radar is operating, at that time, transmitted power of signal, that is there in terms of kilowatts and megawatts. But received power, that is there in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 volt, 10 to the power minus 15 volt. So here, received signal, that is very weak, right? So if you have minimum detectable signal, that is there in terms of 10 to the power minus 15, 10 to the power minus 16, then you can have larger range of radar system, right? And that one can observe based on this relation over here, right? So as if minimum detectable signal, if it is happening by 1 by 16 times, you will be observing radar range that is getting double over here. And that one can observe based on this relation. From this equation, one can understand it. R max is proportional to 1 by S min to the power 1 by 4. So if minimum detectable signal that is happening by 1 by 16 times, then range of radar that is getting double over here, right? So you can say higher the sensitive receiver, higher the range of radar over here, right? I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.